Hello, my dear class 7 students. Welcome to the second period of Delhi Sultanate. In this period, we will discuss about Delhi Sultanate, last Hindu ruler of Delhi, Mamluk or Dev dynasty, Samrat Iltutmish and Razia Sultan. This is a famous incident which was written by Chayan Budrai, who happens to be the court poet of Prithviraj Chauhan. He says that after the second battle of Terrain, Muhammad Ghuri took Chauhan with himself and he blinded Chauhan. But Muhammad Ghuri was aware that Chauhan could fire a arrow towards the voice. So he had arranged the demonstration of this skill of shooting arrow towards the sound, and Chayan Budrai was present over there, who informed Prithviraj Chauhan about the position of the ghori. He said, "Char bas, 24 gaz, angul asht praman, ta upar sultan hai, chuke mat Chauhan." Basically, he gave idea to Prithviraj Chauhan where the ghori was, and Prithviraj Chauhan shot the arrow in the throat of Ghori and Ghori died subsequently. There are many theories how Ghori died and how what was the end of Prithviraj, because according to Chayan Budrai, Prithviraj and he killed each other after this particular episode. So we could not know what is exactly, but we know for sure that after winning India, Ghori could not live a long life, so he had to abandon India. Now, when I considered the timeline of Delhi Sultanate, I realized that the first sultan that could establish on Delhi's throne was from the Mamluk dynasty, that is the slave dynasty, which was appointed by the Ghori, and they ruled from 1206 to 1290. After 1290 till 1230, the Jalaluddin and Alauddin Khalji ruled over Delhi. After 1312, it was the Tughlaqs that took over the Delhi. After Tughlaq, it was Sayyid dynasty, which was given a charge by Timur Lane. And after Sayyid dynasty, it was the Lodi dynasty. The last ruler of the Lodi dynasty, that is Ibrahim Lodi, was defeated by Babur. Thus, Babur could establish Mughal Sultanate after the Delhi Sultanate. As we know that the Ghori could not live a long life after the conquering India, so he appointed his slaves to become a Sultan of India. So the dynasty was called as Mamluk or the slave dynasty. Basically, Mamluk is the Arabic word which means slave, and Ghori appointed Qutbuddin Aibak as the Sultan of India. Because Ghori was not having any male successor to succeed him, he trusted his slave officers than freeborn officers. Reason being, there was a threat of a betrayal, threat of a rebellion from the freeborn officers. That's why the key post of office were entrusted to the slave officers by the Muhammad Ghori. So Qutbuddin Aibak was appointed as the governor for Muhammad's conquered territories of India. But after the death of Muhammad in 206, his empire was divided into his powerful governors, and Qutbuddin assumed the title of a sultan, which was acknowledged by the ruler of the Ghori's Indian position by the Muslim officers in India. But unfortunately, he could not live a long life. So after the accession, he died only after 4 years in an accident happened while he was playing the chogan or the horse polo. So he fell out of the horse and he died. But during his lifetime, he established this Quwat-ul-Islam Mosque in Delhi, and he also initiated the construction of Qutub Minar. The second Sultan was Shamsuddin Iltutmish, who happens to be son-in-law of Qutbuddin, who ascended the throne in 1210 Mamun era. He was the slave of Qutbuddin Aibak. His significant work is he consolidated the Sultanate, Delhi Sultanate. So he established various rules and laws in the Sultanate that gave discipline to the Sultanate. During his last years, he nominated his daughter Razia as his heiress. He did not consider his any surviving son worthy enough to administer. A daughter was preferred as a heir over son. It was good indeed in the medieval time. So Razia al-Din, popularly known as Razia Sultan, so she was a brilliant lady with military capacities. She was a brilliant ruler. What happened? While living for a Gwalior campaign in 1213, Iltutmish gave charge of Delhi administration to Razia, in which she performed excellent. So, she became the first and the only ruler of the Delhi from the Muslim. So, she was the first and last Muslim lady ruler. So, this is what for today. If you have any doubt, please feel to ask by commenting it, and we'll continue the story of Razia and Chahalganis the next lecture. Thank you.